Hi YouTube, this is Lily, and I have an anime release here that I wasn't sure if I was going to buy. I hadn't pre-ordered it last year, but then it got delayed and I got to thinking, and I really like this show. I really want to own this show on Blu-ray, and I hope the first season gets a similar release, but regardless, I'm happy to have the second season. So this is Free Eternal Summer, the premium edition, or the For the Future premium edition. I cut a slit in the plastic, so let's open it up. I feel like Funimation could have done a slightly better job with this box, but that's just me. I'm not a huge fan of this unattractive cardboardy material, but the design itself is pretty nice. Colorful shot of all the characters here, and then there's like, not dolphins, I think these are like whales. Really cute design, little pattern there, Free logo. The top just says, oops, Free For the Future, premium edition. The second season plus OVA. That's the opening, and the back is nothing special. So yeah, opening the box. Water pattern here, that's a cute touch. This is, I think, the towel. I don't exactly remember what comes in this set, so I think these are stickers or decals, something like that. So, Iwatobi Swim Club. And I'm terrible for not knowing exactly what this means, but yeah, this cool design. Okay. I think those are the art cards. I'm gonna just take everything out of the box and set them aside. Alright. These are the art cards. It's been a while since I've seen the season. I watched it while it aired weekly. So, yeah. Nagisa? Anything on the back? No. Just plain white backs, I think, for all of them. So yeah. Haru. Makoto. That was terribly pronounced, I'm so sorry. Rei. Oh, the glare. Rin? Race team, and then our lovely cast. So those are the art cards. So if you want to see the towel, I'll open that up. I hope this can fit in the shot. So yeah, everyone's names, their silhouettes. And the back is just plain white. Then this is probably what convinced a lot of people to get this premium edition, this little art book. Very fan servicey as Free is. It's just a little soft cover, flimsy kind of art book, but it's still really nice. Pictures look pretty good. The colors are very nice and clear. Again, I'm really sorry for the glare. I'm really sorry. Oh, these are really nice pictures.
Don't keep. white boys know the deal, ain't no fucking phony. Big O know the deal, he the one who show me. Watch me light his fucking beat like he fucking told me. Is that your girl? What's a fucking story? She kinda bad, but she riding like a fucking pony. I cut down on her man, be her fucking story. Yeah, I'm talking about you, man, get to know me. Ain't no offense, though, I promise you. If you a real man, dude, you gon' side the truth. But I'm a nice dude, with some nice dreams. But we can turn this to a nightmare, Elm Street. La la la, la 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 la. We're so gone, so gone. Bring out the glass tables. With the 707 now. La la la, la 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 la. We're so gone, so gone. Bring out the glass tables.
Not sure if you can see this, it's like a sketch. This is a really nice art book. I wasn't sure if it would come with some, you know, like episode summaries or something just to fill up the space, or some like anime still shots, screenshots rather. But these are really nice, really nice pictures. They did a good job selecting pictures for this. Final dynamic group shot. Yep. That's the art book. Really nice. I really like this. And the limited edition is included in this set, so this is exactly the limited edition, I think. You get the exact same disc cases, discs, and chipboard art box. So I'll just open this up. Yeah, while this box is disappointing to me, it's like cardboard-y material. Nothing that special. It's not terrible, and it does the job. But, you know, I wouldn't say, like, you know, this is worth a significant portion of the price you're paying for the set. But this is a typical, really nice chipboard art box from Funimation. And as they said, it has like the water splash effect. Can see. Like some sections are a little bit glossy, and yeah. The top, the logo, the bottom, some Funimation information, such. The spine. I don't know if it's gonna focus. And the back. I'm glad that they put all the information on the sheet of paper and kept the art box nice and text-free. It's really nice. And over here it says For the Future, the name of this set. So yeah, this is really, really nice. I would have just gotten this set if it weren't for the art book, honestly. But yeah, it's up to you to decide whether all the extras are worth upgrading from this limited edition to the premium edition. So. Okay, so the first one, this is the Blu-ray. So, cover. Spine episodes 1 through 13 plus OVA on two Blu-ray discs. In the back. Again, really happy that there's no text clouding this art. So, the cover is reversible, I guess. This is the inner part of the insert. Smart design, I like that. And this is the DVD cover that I have to say is pretty appealing to fans of this ship. This is a very, very good picture for those fangirls. It's really nice. It's like it has a nice dreamy quality, and it's just, yeah, it's funny. I love it. Spine, same thing, but episodes 1 through 13 on plus OVA on two DVDs. I don't know if it's gonna focus, but it's not that important. The back, oh, that's so pretty. That's so pretty. Look at the penguin. It really looks like Piplup, the Pokemon. That's really nice art. And inside? I'm really glad they chose different disc art for this. It bothers me a tiny bit when DVDs and Blu-rays have the same art, especially if they're inside the same case. That drives me a little bit crazy. Not a huge deal, but yeah. And so the CDs are nice and slightly like foil. That's nice. And then inside, same deal. I think the information here is pretty much the same as on the Blu-ray. This is the art on this one. Yeah. I have to say, this is a really nice release. I expected a nice release, of course, but everything was really well done. I like all the design choices. I love the fact that there's no text on the back of the art box and on the DVD and Blu-ray cases. And I love the art book, that the art book is a real art book. All the pictures are really nice. If you're debating whether the premium edition is worth getting versus the limited edition, even if you're a hardcore fan, think about whether these extras are worth the price jump. To me, they are. Not necessarily because of the art cards. They're a little bit too fan servicey for me. I'm never gonna use this towel. I would feel too bad. And same thing with these little decals. But I got suckered in by the art book, and it did not disappoint. It's a really nice art book, but again, decide whether that's worth it. Yeah, next I have Death Note Omega Edition and Parasite Collector's Edition pre-ordered. I think that's it for now. I'm wondering if I should pre-order Psycho Pass 2 or just wait a bit. But yeah, this is the unboxing of Free Eternal Summer for the Future Premium Edition. Let me know what you think of the set, whether you bought it or didn't. Or if you're holding off on buying it because Funimation only has the second season, not the first season. I know that was my problem for a while. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching. Bye.